Well, Brian, you finally made it. I'm having a tea party. Sit down.
Yeah, you texted me like 80 times. Look, Stewie, I don't have time to sip air and pretend to eat a wooden hamburger patty.
Yeah? Tell me why you don't have time.
All right, I have time.
And there's nothing pretend about this. Real tea, real milk, and the best honey you'll ever taste in your whole life.
Wow, this is good. Where'd you buy the honey?
I didn't. I'm raising bees.
You're raising bees? Like a beekeeper?
Yep. Mom missed soccer registration, so this is my weekends.
Hmm. Well, I gotta say, you're good at it. You know, you could probably sell this stuff.
Really? You think it's that good?
Yeah, plus it's local, it's straight from the hive. People at farmers markets would go nuts for this. You know, you could probably charge like $20, $30 a jar.
Well, now I'm excited about this, Brian. I feel like an eighth grader who just had sex.
So, you go all the way?
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna need some proof.
How can I prove it? Maybe with Father O'Leary's briefs.
Oh!
The king!
He said he loved me.
So, Brian, this is my hive. Now, how many bees do you think are in here?
I don't know, a million?
No, it's 4,000. Now that seems like nothing because of your idiot million guess. All right, now. If you're going to sell honey at the farmer's market, you need to practice. So you be the salesman, and I'll be the customer. Ooh, what do we have here?
Honey, like the sign says.
I find your attitude cavalier. May I speak to your manager?
Stewie, come on.
I'm sorry, is there a problem here? I was just in the back, and I heard a commotion.
How do we have a back?
I simply came here to inquire about honey, and your employee spoke to me loudly and with profanity.
Stewie, this is ridiculous.
Brian, please. I trust that this handsome, young customer knows what he's talking about. Oh, my. And I thought only bees pour on the honey.
I'm going inside.
So, are you from around here? No, I'm just in town for the John Singer Sargent exhibit at the museum. Really? I've been looking for an excuse to go again. Well, looks like I won't need that audio tour. Great, give me 1 minute. Let me text my fiancé. Your what? Well, you were right. The farmer's market is wonderful. You've got your yoga pants moms. You've got your mixed race kids riding a pony. Confused Jerome.
What is this? A vegetable parking lot?
Now remember to tell customers that this honey is farm to table.
We're not a restaurant. That doesn't make any sense.
Doesn't have to. Say anything to anything, people lose their minds. Just so you know, this is all grass to bottle.
Ooh.
I know, right? That'll be $68.
Is this a superfood?
Total superfood, full of GMOs.
GMOs are bad.
No GMOs whatsoever.
Amazing.
Wow, this is great. We've only been here an hour and we're almost totally sold out.
Yes, I didn't see that coming. Just like Dan Cortez didn't see the end of the 90s coming.
3, 2, 1, Happy New Year!
Dan Cortez was the only thing in the entire world affected by Y2K.